press meeting of the CEV Cup match between Raision Loimu and AB Groningen. I was explaining that you are only the coach here because you have started the trip at 2 o'clock in the night and players need to have some rest before the game. So it's fine.
Exactly.
First of all, of course, what kind of game do you expect?
I think it's going to be a tough game because I think the level of both leagues are similar. Actually, but they have the home advantage and we have 1 day of traveling and we have to switch around a little bit because we just came out of a match last weekend, so it's going to be a little bit harder for us and for them because they have more rest. But as we know, they already played 4 matches the last 7 days, so they are not that rested as well, so it's going to be a tough game.
What do you know about Lloyd?
Everything.
Can you tell us something?
Now, what we know, of course, we have some video footage and we are still busy to get some new stuff. And we know that they have 13 points out of 8 games. And last week, that's a pity, they were out of the Finnish Cup. And we saw some video footage from our hometown, so we know the way they play, and probably they will also know the way we play, so I think this is an advantage of the technical possibilities that we have nowadays from the internet, so I think the games for both teams are very clear.
Okay. Who are the most important players in your team?
The main advantage that we have is that we have a mixture of young and old players, so a lot of experienced players. For instance, Simon is one of the head blockers right now. He played 3 years in the first league in Italy, so he has a lot of experience. My captain is Peter Balla, he's a very experienced player. One of our young guys, Robert Andrigan, number 6, he is from the national team, so. And this is the power of our team. We don't have one player who is above the others, but everybody is playing very well together and it's a very balanced team.
What are your expectations this year in the local, for the Dutch league?
Well, that's difficult to say because up till now we played 6 matches and we won 18 sets and we didn't even lose 1 set until now. So. Next Sunday we have the match against the champion of last year, Dynamo Apeldoorn, who is also now playing in Tampa, I believe, in the European Cup. So this is going to be a new experience, but until now we are the number one in the Dutch league. And as I said, I think the advantage that we have now is that the team is very well balanced and that everybody is making more mistakes than we do, so this is an advantage. But I believe that we can, together with Dynamo, we are the two teams that will decide this year who is going to be champion in Holland. So. But we are also people that are very down with the feet on the floor, so it's still a long way to go. The cup has to start, and this is the first match in European company. So it's also possible that you get an injury, but so far everybody is healthy, so I think we will end up together with Dynamo on battling for the championship at home.
And the Euro.
Because the problem in European volleyball is that we have different styles of teams playing in the different leagues, so you never know if the type of volleyball that we are playing is good enough to play against the Finnish type of volleyball, which is a little bit more harder and a little bit more outside, and we are playing a little bit more the Eastern European volleyball, quicker and different type of setting, so we have to find out in the game. And as I said before, we know, I think both teams know exactly the way we are going to play, and we have to find our solutions during the match.
What kind of game do you expect? Do you know a lot about? They know everything about us, but how about you? Do you know everything about them?
Of course. It's like some course games. Of course, I know about our opponent everything, but it's not true. Of course, I think both the coach know about the opponent, not too much, but I think that tomorrow's deal with like teams when they're same levels teams will be fighting on the court, and I think that our opponent, like head coach said, that they have very good experienced players in their teams, and players who play in high level in other countries, for Italy and for in France. That I think, of course, our opponent from Holland. I think this is a good team. Good, of course, it's a good team. But I hope, and I know our players, and I know our teams, and I know how we can play when we need to play, and I hope that it's very good fighting field tomorrow. And I hope that tomorrow over 1,000, I hope this tomorrow comes. A little bit more spectators, that's usually our games, because for us it's very important games, of course.
Is it an advantage for you to play the first match here and not in Groningen?
No, of course, for me and for our team it's better if we start to play first game in Holland. And because it's for both teams, it's more important second game, more important. What I think about the goal set? Of course, in last week we had bad experience about these rules. But I don't know. For my opinion, it's not very right. I think so. Because I think Internet Federation or European Federation, they must think about these rules and do something. Because.
And Ronald, do you think the same about this?
I think it's a crazy rule, and I think it's bad for the development of volleyball. Because if you are able as a team to win the first match 3-0, for instance, and then in the second match you take the first set, this will give you the opportunity to bring in new and younger players, to give them experience and to develop these players. And now every team is holding back because you know that you have to win the second match as well. So I think it's a crazy rule for the development of volleyball, and that's why I'm a supporting fan of kicking out this rule. And I think my colleague after the last 2 weeks has also the same experience, so I think it's a bad rule for volleyball.
Okay, let's take now the captain of Loimu, Henri Tuomi. In the player's point of view, what kind of game do you expect?
We have a lot of young players that have practically no experience in European leagues, and I expect them to be on fire tomorrow, because this is the point where if you don't fire up for these matches, you don't fire up for any match. We have some guys that want to play professional abroad, and this is kind of a window to show what you can do internationally. And I think we're gonna play good volleyball tomorrow, and I hope they will play too, so we get a good advertisement for volleyball in this area as well.
Henry, how is the feeling just now in your team inside?
We played a lot of matches in a few days, and every match we fight a lot. We fight for every ball, and I think we're in that state that everybody is in that zone, so to speak, that we kind of automatically fight for every ball. We are a very good spirit right now, and it has been 3 years since I played in a team that fights this much in a game, so. Yeah, it's good, and everybody feels confident about tomorrow as well.
Thank you very much, and once again, welcome to Finland, and hopefully we will get a good match tomorrow.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. See you in the